Hello, I'm Callum Burke, and welcome to my video presentation on Das Schwarze Wunder, the West German Economic Miracle. Firstly, I'll discuss the 1945 post-war economic conditions that West Germany faced, going on to talk about Ludwig Erhard's economic reforms and the effect of the currency reform in 1948. Secondly, I shall go on to discuss the economic boom in the 1950s, dealing with the Korean War and mass migration. Then I shall go on in the 1960s to discuss economic slowdown and the reforms attempted by Karl Schiller to stop burnout, ending in the end of the Weichschlusswunder in 1972. Finally, I shall give my conclusion. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy my video.
After 1945, Germany lay in ruins with the prospect of an uncertain and turbulent future. The country had been occupied by the Big Four, and it soon would be divided between East and West. Germany had suffered a large destruction of its infrastructure through Allied bombing and invasion. Dresden had been burnt to the ground, with 718,000 being killed in Cologne. 20% of housing had been destroyed, and food production had seen a decrease by 50% from the start of the war, with an industrial output decreased by 33%. Many of the men of working age had either been killed or crippled as a result of the war, and now Germany was in need of those men to rebuild it. By 1950, Allied dismantling of West German coal and steel industries agreed upon at Potsdam was finished. 706 manufacturing plants in West Germany had been stripped dramatically, reducing steel production by 6,700,000 tonnes. West Germany was in the shadow of hyperinflation, and a black market trade economy had exploded. The Americans released the Joint Chiefs of Staff's Article 1067, directly following Germany's defeat, stating specifically that the economic rehabilitation of Western Germany was strictly forbidden. This stayed in effect for 2 years following the war. However, currency reform was enacted in 1948, replacing the Reichmark with the Deutschmark. Once in place, this allowed for rapidly increasing levels of inflation to be halted, and the black market trading ceased as shops reopened. Ludwig Erhard was appointed Minister of Economics under the chancellorship of Konrad Adenauer. Erhard believed in the concept of the social market economy, which the West Germany government put on the party platform. Erhard made the decision as economic director of the occupational buy zone to lift many of the price controls left by the Nazis in 1948. Despite opposition from the Social Democrats and the Allied powers, it was Erhard's produce of free markets that was a key factor in enabling West Germany's unprecedented growth at the start of the 1950s. The West German extension of martial aid marked the end of the Joint Chiefs of Staff's article, integrating West Germany closer with the Western markets. The amount of monetary aid received to Germany through the Marshall Plan was far outweighed by the costs of war reparations and Allied charges towards occupation. Although monetary aid had little effect, the Marshall Plan offered a moral boost to West Germany with greater Western integration and support. In addition, the effect of the presence of the occupational force is said to be overlooked as contributions made by the local soldiers boosted the West German economy. Soldiers spent their converted marks within Germany revitalising the local domestic economy, buying food, luxury items and entertainment. Close integration with France in the ECSC also further integrated West Germany with Western Europe, unifying the coal and steel industries while extending their market for German products for export.
Jetzt gibt's im Laden Carbonadenschon und Räucherflunder. Jetzt kommt das Wirtschaftswunder. Jetzt kommt das Wirtschaftswunder. Der deutsche Bauch erholt sich auch und ist schon sehr viel runder. Jetzt schmeckt das Eisbein wieder in Aspik. Es gab kein Wunder nach dem verlorenen.
With the outbreak of the Korean War in 1950, the industries of the West were pushed on a war footing, leading to a global shortage in commercial goods. This shortage gap was quickly filled by German products as German enterprise took off. West Germany's workforce was a highly skilled one, and it was bolstered by some 16.5 million Germans joining due to migration and deportation from the Eastern Territories. This combination of the drop in global production of domestic products and an increase in industry growth, driven by constant fresh supplies of labour, allowed West Germany to double its exports value. In addition to this, successful negotiations with trade unions encouraged hard work and long hours at full capacity among the population in the 1950s. This growth of industry was furthered by the extra labour supplied by thousands of Gesellschafter, providing a vital base for the sustainment of the economic upturn with an additional workforce.
Jetzt kommt das Wirtschaftswunder. Jetzt kommt das Wirtschaftswunder. Der deutsche Bauch erholt sich auch und ist schon sehr viel runder. Jetzt schmeckt das Eisbein wieder in Aspik. Es gab kein Wunder nach dem verlorenen Krieg.
However, in the 1960s, West Germany saw a period of economic slowdown compared to the rapid, unsustainable growth witnessed in the 1950s. This was in part due to the construction of the Berlin Wall in 1961, which severed the link of skilled workers fleeing from the east, and in part to the frequent shifting of the Bundesbank, who wished to avoid overheating of the economy by steadying economic growth. Erhard, now Chancellor of the Federal Republic, faced criticism over the economic slowdown and was voted out of government in winter of 1966 to be replaced by the Grand Coalition. The Grand Coalition faced the task of turning West Germany back to the rapid growth of the 1950s by moving away from Erhard's laissez-faire economic policies. Karl Schiller, who had been newly appointed to economic minister, petitioned for new legislation that allowed for greater control of economic policy by government and the economic ministry. Schiller was granted his law for promoting stability and growth in 1967. The new law allowed for the synchronization of national budget plans in order to maximize the effectiveness of fiscal policy. Schiller aimed to use this consolidation of budgets to achieve economic growth, increase employment, increase stability of the Deutschmark, and bring balance to foreign trade. Schiller's economic policy success won his party victory in the 1969 elections, allowing for the creation of a new coalition government with Willy Brandt and the Free Democratic Party. This new coalition of the SPD and the FDP looked to create a wider social budget plan and increase the national social security system. With this obligatory introduction of more social reforms, social costs rose by 10%, reducing West Germany's fiscal flexibility. This increase in social costs and reduced flexibility would be a fatal blow for Schiller and the West German economy, as in 1972, the global economy experienced a downturn, leading to Schiller's resignation, thus ending the Wirtschaftswunder.
In conclusion, West Germany had achieved rapid substantial growth unseen anywhere else in Europe spanning over 3 decades. By maximising what capital stock was left and utilising flows of skilled workforce fleeing westward, West Germany was brilliantly placed for unprecedented growth. West Germany, being born into the new era of the Cold War, provided itself with great opportunities as the German products filled the markets of its NATO members, such as during the Korean War. In addition, Westpolitik and linkages with American industry through the Marshall Plan allowed for technological transfer, allowing for an explosion of foreign trade, overcoming the fear of German products and growth. With a continuation of economic expansion into the 1960s, German domestic demand was revived and therefore economic growth could continue into the 1970s. Thank you for listening, and I hope you have enjoyed my presentation.